With the release of Earth, our dear viewers are in dire need of an emergency update. What champions are you supposed to play in Earth? No problem, we probably drank too many energy drinks and coffee to figure that out for you. But we finally completed our ultimate tier list for Earth. So let's just take a look at it. Our first featured champion is Jace. This man wasn't only annoying in Arcane, no, he's also quite the nuisance in Earth. His laning phase is disgustingly broken as he's able to permanently shove the wave with ease. Now if you add the fact to the mix that he has a melee and ranged form on level 1 by the way, he is able to stack Conqueror insanely fast. If that wasn't bad enough already, he's also able to completely dominate any situation on level 2. All he has to do is spam his first and second ability over and over again. I know, really interactive. But that way, he makes sure that the enemy has no room to breathe. Chunking away the enemy's HP bar with every empowered shock blast leaves the enemy with almost no options to play. Whenever the enemy gets too close, he can also just spam all of his abilities and make sure that they meet their end quite fast. To get out the most of Jace though, you want to properly sequence your abilities. Use your first ability briefly before you use your third ability. That way you remove all the counterplay on the enemy's side. The same applies to your ranged form's second ability. Cast it before you want to go into melee form. You will keep the attack speed bonus and it's going to be an easy kill. But what if you're already in the melee form? You can quickly combo, and as you cast your third ability, you want to swap back to the ranged form and repeat the same range combo as you did before. Being fast enough here removes all available counterplay. For items, there's basically two core options for you. One, Mana Mune, Black Cleaver and Ceruldus Grudge, the default build. Alternatively, you can also rush Yumu's Ghostblade, Black Cleaver and then Ceruldus Grudge. For my part, I'd still advise the Mana Mune build due to Muramana's above bonus damage on your second ability. It's just too broken. The second build would however put more emphasis on just spamming your poke combo. And what runes? Most of the champions in Earth will run a very specific rune page. They'll go for Conqueror, Hunter Vampirism, Hunter Titan and Mastermind. But why? For one, Conqueror grants you the most bonus damage you can ask for. And since you don't have any real cooldowns, you can just spam spells. But what is so special about those Hunter runes? This one is quite obvious. You're constantly fighting and murdering enemies. It would be borderline griefing not to take such high value runes in that game mode. They're just too broken. The same applies to Mastermind. Who cares about sustaining from Sweet Tooth when you can just go to base and come back in an instant thanks to the cannon? I'd personally prefer more gold, more damage to objectives. Earth is all about snowballing, so play it like that. Now let's take a small break for our question of the day. Who's the champion that traumatized you the most in Earth and why? Let me know in the comments below and while you're at it, leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you enjoy the content. Next up comes a champion that's constantly causing nightmares for poor midliners. With Zed, we have another spell spamming abomination. In the early stages of the game, he's just trying to poke you with his first ability. This is probably the most relaxing time you're going to get against him, so enjoy it while it lasts. Upon hitting level 2, you're in for double the trouble as he's now able to use his shadow as well as his shurikens combined. At this point, he can easily kill you if you mess up, but even that pales to his level 3 power spike. Now your game time has ended and Zed begins. You cannot even dream of approaching any minions anymore. Once you try, you'll get instantly chunked or killed. And I really wish I could tell you that you're going to have counterplay. But really, you won't. Oh, and did you think his level 3 was painful? Then wait until he hits level 5 and gains access to his ultimate ability Deathmark. You're going to die on cooldown and if he's mechanically competent enough, you're just gonna sit there and be in pain. Enjoy those times or pick or ban this champion, trust me. For the build, you want something like Yumu's Ghostblade, Black Cleaver and Ceruldus. Sounds familiar. Those items are just too insane and provide him with too much value. And if you want to see more Zed gameplay in detail, you're more than welcome to check out our Earth Zed video. Too much value comes also in the form of Vigar's Cage. This little fella is giga annoying, especially if you pair him with anything that can push the enemy around. And then if you have such a champion, all you have to do is follow our advanced, insanely detailed and overpowered Vigar step-by-step guide. Listen, step 1, place your cage. Step 2, let your ally knock them into the cage. And step 3, immediate profit. Repeat those steps for maximum income. When you start the game, you have to be a little bit more passive though. Your goal isn't to smash lane on level 1, no, not really, it's about pushing waves until you can start playing your game. Level 2 onwards, you have at least access to one damaging ability and your cage. Dying is not so easy anymore and setting up plays becomes possible. Upon reaching level 3, you can finally start following the step-by-step guide. Any question about the process? No? Perfect. Then let's move over to the items. We don't really need any ability haste, so let's just straight up rush Rabadon's death gap. More ability power equals more fun. For our second item, we want the Void stuff, and after that, a nice little Lich Bane. Thanks to the insane amount of AP we are getting, those items really work wonders. So do me a favor, lock in Vigar plus Alistar and see how insanely fun that combo is. Our next champion is quite the odd one. And you're going to play him entirely different than you used to. Normally, you would evolve your first ability and max it ASAP. But in this mode, we don't really care about that one. We want to be annoying, we want to be toxic, so we are going to max our second ability and evolve it first. If the enemy cannot catch you, they cannot kill you. But you being Kha'Zix will always give you the opportunity to kill the enemy. Your champion's damage is just not fair. Simultaneously being the one that decides what fight you want to take makes it really obnoxious to get you killed. Because whatever happens, you can always jump away and run for your life, while obviously spamming your evolved second ability and good luck chasing that champion. But now let's quickly talk about his laning phase. In the early stages, you cannot do much apart from spamming your second ability. Clearing the wave is your primary objective as you want to hit level 5. After that, you can finally start being the toxic champion you are. Nonetheless, there's another way of playing Kha'Zix in Earth. You can just play him in the jungle and speed clear to gain levels. You want to gain as much gold as possible and then punish the enemy with your champion's insane damage output. To put some extra emphasis on that damage output, we recommend the following items. Yumu's Ghostblade for extra movement speed because you don't really need Dustblade here. As your second item, you want a Black Cleaver to add some more value, and for your third item, you're going to complete Mortal Reminder. Have fun playing with this build, it's super fun, but it takes a while to get used to it, but I'm more than certain that you'll make it work. The last of our featured champions is Zarya. By the way, this doesn't mean that other champions are weaker. For example, Master Yi is a complete demon in Earth and should be picked or banned. But seeing 15 videos of 15 different content creators saying how broken Yi is gets a bit boring, don't you think? They are still right though. Let's get back to Zarya, a typical crit AD carry that loves to be annoying with their feathers. But similar to Kha'Zix, we can also play her a bit differently now. On one hand, you may go Infinity Edge, Runan's Hurricane and Cyrilda's Grudge, but on the other hand, you can also go Lethality Zarya. This is something that was viable on PC for like a few weeks at most until Riot bonked her with the Nerf Hammer. For the Lethality build, you want items such as Yumu's Ghostblade for yet again the movement speed, Black Cleaver for some extra pen due to how often you hit them with your spells, and lastly, a Cyrilda's Grudge. You'll be very much surprised by how much damage your character does with either of those builds. But now, let's talk about laning. On level 1, you're going to spam your first ability, be it into the wave or the enemy. Ideally though, you want to hit both while also angling your passive empowered auto attacks in a way that the feathers shoot through the enemy minions into the enemy champions. Starting level 2, you're gonna put on the pressure. Keep on shooting out and recalling the feathers on cooldown. You'll have an insane wave clear, and once you start catching an enemy, they're in for a lot of trouble. And something that's also quite nice about playing Zarya is the ability of having a panic button to avoid anything that could potentially harm you. Featherstorm is just a perfect ability for exactly that purpose. And with Flash and Protobelt, you can quickly relocate yourself and get them with your feathers. Always. And that's it for today's video, friends. I hope you enjoyed the Earth tier list as much as we did while we made it. If you did, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel to never miss any content update in the future. See you soon.